November 28, 1967, Cambridge, England. Jocelyn Bell is an astronomy student examining radio wave data from the most sensitive telescope of its kind.
Jocelyn Bell is looking for quasars, objects that are 100 times brighter than the Milky Way.
She analyzes the 100 feet of radio wave data generated every night.
And it's just all on chart paper. I mean, miles and miles of chart paper. That's the way they did it back then. And she's going through and looking for, you know, radio sources.
What they're expecting to see is radio emission in continuous but somewhat random bursts.
Instead, something else grabs her attention. It's a regular pulse.
What she sees is a signal spaced precisely 1 1/3 seconds apart.
It's very regular, like a clock, better than any clock, in fact, that we could build.
The mysterious pulse is not from little green men, but from something just as incredible. Jocelyn Bell's LGM-1 signal comes from a new cosmological phenomenon. In February 1968, Bell and Hewish publish the discovery of a super-dense, highly magnetized celestial body, a neutron star.
What happens when a giant star dies is it collapses, and it collapses down into a neutron star. So dense, a sugar cube piece this big would weigh more than 10,000 aircraft carriers.
And it's spinning very fast. And because it has these strong magnetic fields, it's sending out beams of radio energy and also light into space.
It's giving off very powerful jets, only in two directions.
As the star is rotating, the signal, if it's pointing towards us, can be detected. It's kind of like a lighthouse. So as the lighthouse spins, you see the light, you see the light.
The pulsating neutron star responsible for the LGM-1 signal gets the nickname Pulsar.
The theory that Anthony Hewish presents to the astronomical world turns it upside down, and in fact, brings him the Nobel Prize for one of the greatest discoveries made.
The discovery lays the foundations of a pathway through the cosmos. Because pulsars are more than just another type of star, they are beacons for galactic navigation.
As we've begun to map the universe, we've now discovered over 1,000 of these pulsars.
Any intelligent species will know about all the pulsars in the neighborhood, so you can put them on spacecraft as kind of markers on a map.
The NASA teams behind the Voyager and Pioneer missions include maps of the pulsars nearest our planet. If intelligent life intercepts these deep space probes, they'll have a clear map to us on Earth.